We talked about starting an exercise program a little earlier. Many people have good intentions to do it, but don't stick with it. What are some of the biggest mistakes people make that end them back up on the couch?
The most important thing that I always, always, always communicate with the people that I work with is what brings them to me and what is it that motivates them. Because motivation is short term. People can get motivated, you know, to go to a wedding or go to a high school reunion. What happens when they hit that goal? The motivation is gone. Mm-hmm. So whatever they've achieved to that point, it kind of like goes down the drain. So the most important thing for people is commitment. And the commitment that people come up with, you know, to start an exercise program. You know, they don't change their lifestyle. Oh yeah, they increase exercise, but they still eat the same. They still earn the same amount of stress. They still don't sleep enough. They still don't rest enough. They go through exercise regimens when they challenge the body too aggressively and the body gets inflamed. So they cannot really achieve the results they want to achieve. And they eventually at one point they collapse. So the main idea behind achieving your goals with exercise is your commitment and being committed to the right goal and to the right idea, which is ultimately your health.
What are some of the more common conditions that you see in your practice, and how successful can those conditions be treated?
I mean, I have seen really, really a lot of different injuries and different conditions. We see a lot of people with spinal injuries. It's very interesting how little attention is anybody pays to the mechanics of movement, you know, mechanics of posture. Because a lot of times, you know, people come to me, they're like, oh my God, I have a prolapsed disc, or I have a herniated disc. I've never been in a car accident, I've never had an injury, but I have this happening to me. And, you know, they go to the doctor, you know, the doctor says, well, you have to have a spinal surgery. And nobody down this chain addresses how are they nutritioning. Because, I mean, here is the thing, you know, high sugar-based diet is going to create inflammation in the body. That inflammation in the body is overall is going to create weakness in the tissue. And then they sit on their chair all day long, and here is the injury happening in the body. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of people coming to me also with fibromyalgia. That is another one that is so, strictly food related. A lot of allergies to dairy or gluten that are not detected. And, you know, people ache and hurt all over. And, you know, they put on medication and that cycle just kind of like really starts to spiral down. And when somebody like that comes to me, I cannot start them on an exercise program because they're already inflamed. So me creating a program for them will create even further inflammation. So this is where it's kind of like, you know, let's address what happens in the body first and then start from there. Another interesting issue that I see a lot is joint replacements and how, you know, a lot of times people feel like, oh yeah, you know, I had the knee replaced, so I can go and do whatever I want to now. There is a limitation there. You know, that joint is artificial now, so there will be structural limitations that we just have to respect. And that's all it is. We have to respect the body's ability to do things. And but it's really interesting work, you know, to be able to work with all these different conditions and help people.